We'll check these are going.
My two turning to grass, not talking, just liquidating. They were flowers, my men, two geraniums. And the killers sit in prison, smelling of spring, watching the mountain change shape in the sun.
Do you want me to kill them? Is that what you want?
No, I talk because... How can I not when you head for the door? I don't like you with that thing in your pocket. I don't want you going out to the field.
Is that all?
Why aren't you a girl? Oh, you'd not be going anywhere. We'd sit here stitching pretties together, knitting dogs for children.
Mother of mine. Shall I take you with me?
What kind of place is the vineyard for an old lady like me? What did you have in mind? A quick roll into the vine?
Oh, you ancient old lady. Ancient old lady.
That's what your father would do. Anywhere he could. And your grandfather? He put a sun in every corner. That's the kind of stock you're from. Suits me fine. Let the wheat be wheat and the men be men.
And what about me?
What about you? Well,
it grieves you? Why?
I don't know. It just does. Oh, she's a nice girl, I know. Isn't she? Well-mannered, hard-working, bakes her own bread, I know. But when I hear her name, I feel like someone's hit me on the forehead with a rock.
Oh, come on.
Come on, what? You're the only one left, and I have this feeling you're going.
Not without you.
Yes, without me. I'm there every morning to mind your dad and brother. What if I wasn't? And if Felix died, then somebody buried him in the ground next to them. I'm not going to let that happen. I tell you now, that's not going to happen. I'd single-handedly dig him up with these fingernails and mash him to pulp against the churchyard wall. I'm sorry. How long's it been?
3 years. And I've got the vineyard.
3 years. She had somebody else once, didn't she?
I don't know. Maybe. How else do you see who to marry?
What's there to see? I saw your father. He was killed. And all I saw was the wall.
She's all right and you know it.
Well, who said that I didn't? What was her mother like, though, I wondered to myself.
Who cares?
Son?
Mother?
Tell me, when would you like me to ask for her?
Ask for her on Sunday!
I'll give her the bronze earrings. Antiques those are. And you
what?
Need to buy.
What do I need to buy?
Stockings.
There's so much I have to learn from you.
Embroidered stockings. And 2 new suits for yourself. I'll make it 3. Here are all the sons I've got. Away with you now. You're too big for kisses. Save your kisses for your bride. After she is one.
I'll visit her tomorrow.
You do that. And see if you can't just make me happy with 6 grandsons. However many you want. Being as your father didn't have time for so many.
The first one's for you.
Girls too, mind. I want to sit and embroider and make lace calmly.
You'll like my wife.
I'll love her.
I'm going.
Oh, and turn over the patch by the mill. It's a mess.
I know. I've done it.
God be with you. She sways and sits.
The hand of a man, the sweetest man.
Oh, come in.
How are you?
As ever.
I was down by the shop, so I thought I'd come and see you. That road gets long each time, I'm sure.
I haven't walked to the top of it in 20 years.
Well, you're not soft.
Am I not?
It's happening out there. The other day, they brought back my neighbor's son from the field, both arms chopped off by a machine.
Raphael?
That sweet boy. So there you have it. It's not safe out there. I think of your boy and my boy, our dead boys, that they're best off out of the way sleeping. Been exposed to the kinds of risk of having their arm suddenly chopped off by a machine.
Don't waste your garden comforts on me.
Well,
might you say.
And your other one, how is he?
Out, working.
He brought the vineyard finally.
He did. He was lucky.
A marriage next.
Tell me something.
What can I tell you?
You know this girl?
Lovely, really.
Yes, I know.
Oh, there's not much to say. She lives so far from town. Just her and her father and, that maid that reared her. Nobody really knows. She's used to her solitude, you know. The next house must be 15 miles away. But she's strong, equipped for life.
And your mother?
I did know her. A fine-looking woman, a saintly-looking woman. It's not much of a housewife if you catch my drift.
Share a room with them, did you?
Well, you asked. And if you didn't want to know the facts, I'm not saying she went elsewhere. I'm not saying that. Nobody's saying that. She was proud.
That's enough.
Well, you asked.
And you knew. I wish nobody knew anything. That they stung you like nettles for mentioning their name.
Oh, do you understand, he's a good boy, yours.
He is. And I look after him for that. They tell me she had another one once.
She did. He's married to one of our cousins now. But they've all forgotten that.
Not you, though.
Well, now.
Come on, out with it, girl. The splinter, who was he?
Leonardo.
Leonardo who?
Felix.
Felix!
Come on, girl. Hold steady. Where's the good?
No good. No good. But tell me, how does the mother know?
Better to spit than to kill. Come on, hold steady. Where's the good? Don't spill it for him. It's your boy's happiness, this. Don't spill it. You're not young, nor am I. It's our job now to keep our mouths shut.
I won't say a word.
There's a girl. Ooh. Nothing to be said.
Life.
I better head back in and put out the lunch. They'll be hungry and dirty as lambs.
Have you seen the heat today?
Woo! The little one's out taking water to the field looking like little crispy chickens. You take care now.
And you.
Just come back from the blacksmith's. More shoes. How many's that? They just jump off in these days. I don't know. Maybe it's the stones.
Not that you ride him.
When do I ride him? Hmm? Hardly ever.
The women across the road thought they'd seen you on the other side of the plain.
Which women?
The fruit pickers. Getting capers. Yesterday. I was surprised, I must admit. It wasn't you, was it?
No. What would I be doing out on that piece of wasteland anyway?
That's what I said. But the horse was running.
Did you see him?
Mother did.
She with the baby?
Yes. Do you want some lemonade?
I had to wait to get the beef weight. They always make you stand around.
Good price?
Medium price.
It's so old, this dress. Feel that. And he needs a hat that ties on and won't pull off.
I'm going to see
him. Miles! He's only just asleep. Little rose bush.
Who in the hell is galloping that horse around like a fiend? He's flat on his side, his eyes like grapefruit.
Me!
Sorry I spoke. Your horse.
Leonardo's just come back from getting the wheat made.
To wear out any way you wish.
Cold enough?
Yes.
Have you heard they're asking for my cousin? Tomorrow. Wedding within the month. I'm sure they'll invite us.
Are you?
Can't say his mother's hopping for joy.
Why should she be? With that bride?
What's wrong with her? You're so hard on her always.
He'd know though, wouldn't he?
I left. I left! Remember? Hmm? Oh, God, please don't cry. Don't!
I'm not. Shall we go see her son?
Hello! Excuse me, can I come in?
Come in then, long legs. Tell me the news.
I saw him at the shop today.
Who, the groom?
Yes, the groom. I saw him.
On his own?
No, with his mother. Tall, serious.
Serious, yes.
Like she's sucking lemons or something.
It's not the way I do if I was buying those things.
Well, they're not short of a bit. Tell me then, what did they buy?
Everything. Everything you'd ever want for your wedding. They've got these stockings that are like, they've got these pictures embroidered on them. They were mine, I would never take them off. They've got a bird flying here, and a boat with sails here, and a rose bush. Here, here, look!
Look at you!
With the stock and seeds and silk and everything. She's so lucky.
She is.
I wish I was her.
It's two families with something in the pot.
I still can't have the wedding. They've got these stockings that are like
a— No one gives a damn about the wedding!
Leonardo! I'm sorry, I thought you'd want to know.
Ignore him.
I think I better go now.
Happy to be so objectionable?
Who asked your opinion?
Fine.
What's wrong with you? You're brave like a hailstorm. I don't know what's happening inside your head. Please don't do this to me.
Leave it.
No. Will you look at me? Tell me what you're thinking.
I just want some peace.
Where are you going? Leonardo!
Stop asking questions! Will you?
It's enough!
Where's your watch?
Here.
We have to get back again.
I know.
They live so far away.
It's good land, though.
But where is everyone? 4 hours, not a house or tree?
It's dry.
If this was your father's, it would be covered in trees.
What, with no water?
He'd find water. He planted a vineyard and 10 cherry trees in our 3 years together. Plus the 3 walnut trees by the mill, and another bush plant, Jupiter, which didn't survive in the end. Big, pinky red flowers like raw flesh.
I guess she's getting dressed.
I've been traveling long.
4 hours.
You came the direct way.
I'm too old for that river path.
She gets nauseous.
Excellent hemp this year.
Very good.
You know, when I got started, we got nothing, not even hemp. We bullied it, we wept over it, and now...
It yields no complaints. I'm not here to beg.
You're richer than me. Vineyards are golden. Every grape. It vexes me, I must tell you, that our lands are, you know, separate. It's a distance. I enjoy a, you know, a wholeness. One of my grievances is that they won't, for all the gold I wave at them, sell me that small orchard in the middle of my fields. It lodges there and here, like some thorn.
There's always something.
I'd like to hire 20 pairs of bulls, drag your vineyards across the fields, and replant them here. That would make me happy.
Why?
Because what's mine is hers, what's yours is his. And together, it would be beautiful together.
And less traveling, too.
I will sell up and buy here. Just wait till I'm dead.
Sell? Oh, no! Buy, mother, buy it all! If I'd had sons, we'd own everything by now, the whole mountain. It may not be the best land, but with work, it comes good. And no one passes by to steal your fruit. It lets you sleep easy at night.
You know I am here.
I do.
And?
It's fine. I talked.
My son's got what it takes. The means and the know-how.
I daughter too.
It might not look like it, but my boy's not been with a girl before. In the glare of the sun, he'd be white as a sheep.
My girl is. What can I tell you? She's up at 3 each day to bake bread so it's warm and fresh for breakfast. She's no chatterbox. She sews all kinds of things. She's soft as a lamb's wool, but give her a rope. She can bite it in two.
God bless your house.
God bless it.
Son, when would you like your wedding to be?
Next Thursday.
Thursday! That's my daughter's 22nd birthday.
Is it? The age my first son would be if he weren't dead. A bristly chinned man. He was quite a man already before knives were invented.
You shouldn't dwell on that.
Well, I do.
Thursday then, Gregory.
Agreed.
You and I will take the bride and groom to church in a carriage at some distance from here. The rest of the party can make their way by cart or horse, whatever it is they've got.
Good.
She can come in now.
Are you happy, girl?
Yes.
Why the long face? This is your new mother.
I said yes. I am happy. Why would I say yes otherwise?
Of course you are. Look at me.
My wife is fit.
Quite a girl. What does marriage mean? Do you know?
I think so.
A man, some children, 4 stone walls.
Well, not very much then.
It's enough if they all survive. We've brought presents for you.
Thank you.
Shall we?
Not for me. Son?
Thank you.
Have some wine.
He doesn't drink wine.
Oh. Good. Good boy.
Back tomorrow.
What time?
5.
I'll be here.
Nothing feels right when I'm not beside you, and well, I don't know how to speak anymore.
It won't be like that when you're my husband.
Exactly.
Well, the sun won't wait. Any other business?
I don't think there is.
I'll see you soon.
God keep me.
Goodbye, daughter.
I'll walk out.
Nothing.
Well, I want to see.
Well, I don't.
Not even the stockings. Well, come on. Embroidered right the way up, I hear. Hello?
I said I don't want to see them.
Well, good grief. The girl doesn't actually want to get married.
Whoa!
Sweetheart, what? Princess of mine, don't be vexed. But what possible reason do you have?
None.
Now let's just open these up and see what they brought.
No!
Listen, my girl.
I said, no!
Fighting like a man!
Sorry. I heard a horse last night. Did you?
No, when?
A quarter to three?
No, must have got lost straight from the pack.
It wasn't lost. There was someone on.
How do you know? Did you see
that? I did. And he was by your window. I nearly screamed.
Was he? Quarter to three? My fiance, was it? He's never done that before.
No, it wasn't your fiance.
Who was it then?
Leonardo.
That isn't true.
It is true.
Keep your words and take it back. Why would he come here?
I don't know. But he was here.
On love she sips, upon her lips, the kiss of a man, the sweetest man.
Cut the flowers, ring the bells, oh yes, oh yes, oh yes. Oh, that's better, some air.
There's fire coming off the walls.
Cold that skin even at dawn.
Mother grew up in a place full of trees, didn't she? On fertile land.
Well, happy her.
She shriveled up out here.
That's how it went. What can you do?
That's how it always goes. Boiled alive. Ow, you're hurting me.
Well, I'm trying to make this bit curl so it falls down gently. Oh, what a beauty you are. My birthday girl.
Listen,
because I'm envious. You'll have a man from tonight, lucky thing. A man to warm your skin against in the dark. A mouth you can brush with your own, the weight of his
tongue.
Mornings are best. Waking him beside even feeling his breath on the curve of your shoulder like a tiny nightingale.
I don't want to hear this.
Oh, come on, girl. What do you suppose a wedding is? You think it's the cakes or the field flowers? Oh, no, my lamb. It's all in the bed. The gleaming white bed and the man and the woman.
You shouldn't tell me.
Who else is going to? You can't take it from me. Anyway, it's lovely.
Or not. Maybe it's not.
I'm going to weave this orange blossom through your hair like a queen.
Let's see.
What's wrong?
Nothing.
Now what kind of time is this to go getting sad? Here, give me the flower. What do you think you're doing? Flinging this garland away. Are you looking for trouble? Lift your head up. Hey! Now don't you want to get married? Now that's true, you must tell me. You still got time to change your mind.
I've got a bad feeling. Dark clouds. Normal, probably. Completely normal.
Do you love him?
Yes, I love him.
Of course you do.
It's such a big step.
And we all take
and
it.
I said I will.
I'm going to get on with things while we talk.
They'll be here soon.
We all left home hours ago.
How far? Tell me again, is the church?
10 miles by stream, 20 by the road. Wake up, bride, wake up, look at you, my girl. Wake up, bride, wake up, give us all a twirl.
You better let them in.
Here
Leonardo.
Hello.
You're the first one here.
You're looking as if I'm not invited.
No, you are invited.
So here I am.
And your wife?
She's coming in the cart. I'm on the horse.
Did you pass anyone?
Yes.
You'll kill it. Racing your horse round like that.
And when he dies, he'll be dead.
Sit down. No one's up yet.
The bride's not up yet.
I'm just getting her dress.
The bride is happy. Is she?
How's the baby?
Which baby?
Your baby. Is he coming today?
No. Wake up, bride, wake up. Come and take your man. Wake up, bride, wake up. Take him while you can.
He'll be here soon.
Oh. She's got a braided garland, has she? Which she shouldn't have. A single one would suit her best. And the groom. Did he bring the orange blossom for her dress?
He did. Who wants to know? You can't come out like that.
Why not?
Why are you asking about my orange blossom? Did you think it was supposed to be you?
No. Why should I think that? I'm nothing to you. Remember? I'm meaningless. A hut? And two cows? How much more meaningless can you get?
What are you doing here?
I'm a guest at your wedding.
As I was at yours.
You tied the knot of my wedding.
You think so?
No gold to spit at. Isn't that the
truth?
You're
a liar. Great, that's enough.
I need to stop this. I'm a warm-blooded man, and I don't want these hills to hear
me. You think they wouldn't hear me?
I said enough.
Why am I even talking to you?
That's right. It's finished.
Oh! You know, it makes me boil. You coming here, spying on my wedding day, asking about my orange blossom? Get out. Go on! Get out! Go and wait for your wife outside!
This is too much.
I can't. I have to talk.
No!
I need
no,
to talk to you. Please! I've been thinking. I've been thinking. All this time, I've been thinking. Day and night. Trying to work out whose fault it was, who is to blame, who's guilty. And all the thinking, all the days and nights just leave me with faults and blame and how young we were and guilt.
I was a motherless girl in the middle of the desert. What was I supposed to do? If there was you and your horse, you'd have taken me, all of me, wrung me dry of all I had. But I'm strong. And I hold my head up, and today is my wedding day. I'm getting married. Not to gold, but to a priceless man who I will shut myself up with and love more than ever I did you. Stay where you are!
That's right!
I had to see you.
Well, here I am.
That's just pride. It's just pride, and it gets you nowhere. At least in misery and guilt. Not saying anything when you're burning alive? Being unable to say forgive me. I know where it gets you. Not seeing you, not speaking to you, refusing
to. I can't listen to you!
And I can't see you! I knew you were lying awake. That you couldn't sleep night after night. And what did I do? I mislead you. It turns you on the
ball. What do you know?
Come. Whatever the fire, it reddens the flames. I prayed it would go, that what I felt would change. I built walls to hide it, but they can't. What can walls change? Once roots have taken hold in the marrow of you, walls don't stop anything.
How does hearing your voice do this to me?
Don't stop listening.
You allowed me.
I shouldn't be here.
I'm drunk. I'm under a blanket of frozen. I can feel you dragging me, and I can't stop it. I can't breathe, I'm drowning!
You have to get out, you have to get out now!
This is the last time I do this, I promise.
Right, no!
The only time, I promise!
Your bridal madness. There has been pieces inside me rotting from keeping him away so long. And today he arrives and I stand looking at his arms move like
he's the thief.
I have to say these things! I cannot say them anymore. I'm married. You are getting married!
Hey. Feel
as my goddamn mother! But I tell you, I'm not going anywhere. I'm stopping right here, in the same square inch as you.
Wake up, Bridie, wake up. The sun is up and bright. Wake up, Bridie, wake up until it sets tonight.
That was me. Wide-eyed. I could have fit a whole countryside into my heart.
Come on, let's go.
In the cart!
In the cart, yes, let's go!
Down the whole fettered bloodline of knife-wielding gangsters.
Come on, Mother, not today.
Easy to say.
I look mad, don't I? I am mad, from not yelling as much as I should. There's a shout behind my chest, crouching, always ready. I have to rein it back, keep it stuffed in the cupboard. They wheel off your dead ones, and it's time to stop your mouth up. That's it. Then people criticize you.
It's not the day for today. It's all I was saying.
When it's there, it's there. And after today, I'm on my own.
Dreaming of new small friends.
Babies. Dreaming of grandchildren, yes.
I hope they have plenty. They're needed on this land. Strong arms, not weekly wages. You'd be shocked by the weeds and stones they creep in from nowhere. Grandchildren's arms. They've got to own the ground. Boss it around. Force the seats up. Yes, they need to have a lot of boy children.
And girls. Men are thin air. They keep knives in their pockets. Girls stay in the house.
They'll have plenty of both, I think.
My son's from good seed. He'll cover her well. His father could have planted me a whole crop of sons.
I wish they could do it all in a day. Turn out two or three big fellows by morning.
We'll wish away. It takes time to grow a child. Which is why it's a thing to see the blood of one spilled. A fountain that lasts for moments which costs us years to fill up. When they brought me to my son, he was in the street. I wet my hands in his blood and licked it. Because it was mine, you know.
Just you bide your time, Mother. Your son is strong. My daughter's sturdy.
Yes. I'll bide my time.
Is the weed pudding done?
All done.
Blessings on them.
Thank you.
Is there a party done?
A small one. Before people have to head back home, you know.
Seen the church so full.
What a turnout.
Full family tree.
Who don't usually leave their houses.
Your father showed you read.
There were cousins I didn't even know I had.
From up the coast.
Who thought the horses were after them.
are you thinking?
Nothing.
Those marriage words can weigh a girl down.
Like stones.
But they shouldn't. They should be light as doves.
Are you staying tonight?
No. My house is empty.
You shouldn't go back alone.
See this dancing? All the way from the sea, huh?
Those are my husband's cousins. Hard as nuts when it comes to dancing.
Yeah, it does one good seeing them. What must this little house be thinking?
Did you like your orange blossom?
Yes.
It's wax, so you'll have it forever. I wanted to get more for your hair.
Can I take out your pins?
I'll be back.
Grandfather.
Not his build, but you, that same twinkle in your eye. So, where's my girl?
They're, taking her pins out.
So listen, there's a plate of ham and I'll know your life is evil, your mother thinks you don't drink. A fair few glassfuls of some good tummy wine down in the lark, body shop. Just in case you're, awake at midnight.
Oh, midnight tonight, I'll not be thinking of food.
You might not, but your wife might be.
You're here, I tell you, you're here.
I'm just waiting for the bride.
Go to call me.
No.
I thought you were calling me.
She's just getting her pins out.
The heroines are. Come on, this way. Oh.
So tight. She's so old. And I'm young.
Not now.
Well, why not now?
There's people everywhere.
Who cares? We're married.
But no.
worried about tonight?
No! It's not you. Don't go. Don't leave me on my own. I'm sorry. Sorry to interrupt.
It's all right.
Have you seen my husband anywhere?
No.
I can't find him anywhere. And I can't see his horse.
Maybe he took it for a treat.
Aren't you two the lucky ones? All these people wishing you well.
You know, I sort of wish they'd go home. I think the bride's getting tired.
Oh, what's up, little one? Oh, there's a thumping in my head. Mountain bride's head don't thump. She's yours now. You'll have to find the cure.
Let's dance.
No. I just need to lie down.
I'll come with you.
No, you won't. With everyone still here, just let me rest.
Of course. As long as you're better by tonight. I hope so.
Son,
where have you been?
Out there dancing. Are you happy?
I'm happy.
Well, where's your wife?
Ah, she's resting. Not a good day for brides.
No, there's none better, like claiming a legacy, a day of flowering and planting trees.
Are you leaving?
Yes.
Alone?
Not alone, with a suitcase full of men who were boys and fights that were had.
Oh, but the fighting's stopped now.
Ah, but I'm a woman and women don't know how to stop.
Well, I won't ever stop being your son.
Love her well. And if she ever gets proud or remote, you just remind her what's what. Your love and your strength. Maybe squeeze her a bit tight, bite her till it hurts, then kiss her very, very gently. Don't allow her to be guarded. Let her know you're the man of the house. Your father taught me these things. He taught me, so I'm teaching you, man to man.
What would I do without you?
Where's my daughter?
She's in her room.
It's the Red Spring Dance, right in her room.
She's not in her room,
isn't she?
You have to dance with me then.
She must be on the balcony.
I'll get her.
They're starting without you.
She's not there.
Isn't she?
Well, she can't be.
Where is the bride?
We're looking for her.
She's not dancing.
The whole flock of them. Look again.
I've looked.
Where is she?
No, I can't find her.
Wait a minute. Stop that noise. How can you have lost your daughter? What is this? Where is the bride?
On the back of Leonardo's horse. He's taken her. They've gone.
My daughter?
Your daughter.
You're lying, girl.
She's not. She means it. He's taking my son's wife.
Who's got a horse? A horse? Somebody give me a bastard horse!
For everything I have, my eyes, my tongue.
I have a horse.
Go, son.
You can ride my horse.
Go. Don't go, but go. Catch them. I'll follow.
There's some mistake. It's not her. She might be down the well.
With any shame she might, and she married to my son, we're two groups now, my family and yours. Now get out there, all of you, wipe the dance dust off your feet, we're going to help my son. Two sides, because he still has some family. Now get out there, use every road you can find. Here we are again, there will be blood again. Now go! Go!
Can I come into your house? Sit by your hearth, roast by your fire. I like to be held, touched, melted, like glass in flames. I'm cold. The doors and windows you leave open chill me. I slip myself through the cracks, trying to get warm. I'm the swan in the river,
the cathedral window, the eyes of the church. You think the morning's coming? It's only me. Where is everybody?
Once the moon comes out.
Which the moon can't shine through leaves.
Well,
we should let them be.
It's a big old world.
Shh.
What?
What?
No horse?
No. No horse. Just the night on night watch. Frogs. Crickets.
I wonder what they're doing.
What do you think? He'll be loving her now.
Well,
at least they're following their hearts.
Her fresh blood spill.
Better left out on the earth than left inside rotting.
Well,
they'll find them spent like two empty jugs. Though there's some cloud tonight, maybe they won't.
Did you see the groom's face?
Yes.
The color of ash. A streak of white flames.
Can they break through that ring?
Unlikely.
Unlikely.
It's good horse.
But it's carrying two.
Ah.
How can they see with all these trees?
The moon.
The moon.
The moon.
Here comes the moon.
Shining silver on the poor bride's face.
It can't take long now.
You know the snow loves me. I ride her many back. Water likes me too. Do I like him? He gets me down. Swallows me whole. Who's that? Hiding. I heard a sob. Did you hear a sob? My cheeks will be rouged tonight. Those branches get out of my way. You kill me with your shadows. I'll edge along you with a scratch of brightness. I heard it again. Come out here. I'll make your horse shimmer like diamonds. One big diamond. Soon.
Got it! again? Flighty bitch! She's gone. And they're getting near. The splintered screams won't make it past the burble of this river. Or the tops of these trees. Come on! I'm tired. Bottom drawers are open. Get the white threads out, lay them on the bedroom floor. There's bodies with wounded necks coming. Be prepared! It's not a bird wing tonight. The wind will pick the moans up in her skirts and stifle them. Tree tops. Or on the soft mud. Get out here when I tell you to, little bitch. Make their waistcoats shine. Move the buttons apart so the blades can't miss.
Let them miss. Make them tie slowly. Let the blood trickle down my hand like a drone. Then a spurt. I quite like it like that.
Who cares what you like? Here. Don't let them pass.
They're here.
Moon! Get out of here! Give me light! They're mine. Up here!
I don't even know.
No, they are.
I
heard his horse. Just now, I heard it just then.
Well, no.
There isn't anybody else's horse. It's the only damn horse in the world. If you want to stay, then stop talking.
I don't even know.
From now.
I don't even know.
Now they're up here. This is the right place.
I know. Because this isn't my arm. This is my brother's arm, my father's arm, the arms of all my family who aren't here anymore. This arm could rip this whole forest out till all these trees were upside down. My family are here. And I can feel their teeth clenching together so tight that they can't breathe. So let's go up this path right here, right now.
Did you say ah?
No. Go quickly, get going and hide yourself. Go now.
Final one. Would you excuse me?
me. It's quite a surprise this late to meet. It's a little chilly, huh?
Where are you going?
Well, quite a distance from here.
Have you been walking long?
Yes.
Did you see a horse with two people, a man and a woman?
Did I? Well now, aren't you a handsome one? I bet you look like an angel when you sleep.
I'm looking for a man and a woman on a horse.
Look at this back of yours. You know, if I were you, I'd be lying flat on this broad back of yours, now walking round on wretched feet. It's so much less to carry the weight on.
Have you seen them near here?
No. No, I haven't seen them yet. Soon, they're coming soon. Can't you hear them?
No.
Don't you recognize this path?
I don't know.
No, but I don't care.
Don't worry, he'll come back to you. I know it well around here. I could take you.
Just tell me and I'll find it. Is it this way?
No, this way.
This way.
Just up here.
First. Who put the bridle on?
I did!
Whose hands put my feet in the stirrups?
Mine! Which are yours? Mine did. I want to rip your veins open and spit out your life. Leave me alone! Go away! Go and die!
I tried not to, you do know that. I built walls between our houses. I put sand in my eyes when I saw you. Oh, my mind was choking with weeds, my blood was turning black. My horse made me, so it's not my fault, he did. I warned him not to, I turned him round and round and round again. Oh, but it was you. Oh, this hair. It was a horse who made me, and the smell of you.
How? I am a shard of straw blowing at you. I don't want you at bedtime or breakfast, but I cannot not have you anymore. You will be
punished for this. I have a husband now. I have a husband. Go! You should go, please go. Leave me here, you run!
Break the birds out! Bring on the day we're wasting our lives here. Oh, I have to be somewhere I can love you.
I'll curl up in your naked ball at your feet and watch you sleep. Your dog. I look at you and the rest burns away.
Oh, we've both burned away. Two heads of corn in the same flame. Let's go.
Where?
I don't care. Wherever the men surrounding us can't get to. Someplace I can look at you.
Someplace you can flaunt me. Dog wedding. Dog woman wedding. She's blown behind me, the breeze.
I would leave you if I could. I would have done it already if I were able. I can't. I can't. Because we're clamped together by nails of moonlight. Your hips and my waist. They're coming.
Run! I should die right now with these trees laughing at me. Cold my feet in the water and I get swum in the lake.
And they're getting close.
Go!
No!
Go!
No! You go. Go on, run. Are you sure? Is that what you want? Well, if you lose me, it's because I'm dead.
And me, if you lose me.
Thank you.
Once a man fell down a well. Splish, splash, splash, he sounded. Had he not fallen in, he would not have drowned. Two torrents stilled at last in the rocks. Two lads buried underneath horses' feet. Such a lovely night to die on, such a shame. Out on the riverbanks, a bright red groom and a speechless lover, muddy stretched out in their ivory shirts. I'm being followed here by a cloud of birds. Better watch out for your eyes. Their teeth ended up scattered like fistfuls of snow. Their eyes crushed like petals both. The bride's coming back, alive, dress soaked in blood, blood in her hair. But the boys, they're covered in blankets now. They'll be carried home, the pair of them, up on the shoulders of whoever's fit. The upstanding youth. And there we are. They did as they needed. Justice served on the dirty, brown, moonlit floor. One of them is dark-skinned, and the other is dark-skinned.
This one has flies in his mouth.
The boy's shoulders will get tired carrying this weight. Handsome boys marching death through the air. On a day marked out for this event, between 2 and 3 in the night, 2 men killed each other for love. A small knife, a gentle weight in the palm of one's hand. Delicate penetration of surprised flesh. In the place where the dark root of the unfurled scream waits, tangled and trembling. On a day marked out for this event, between 2 and 3 in the night, 2 great big boys ended their evenings with yellow lips.
Shut it, girl. I'm trying. Cut it out. Where is everyone? My son, for instance. An armful of flowers, a whisper behind the mountains. Shut it or leave. I don't want crying in the house. It means nothing to me. When I'm left on my own, I'll weep myself. But not from my eyes. From the soles of my feet up the bones of me from the floor. Like dried blood.
Don't stay here. Come back with me to my house.
I'm staying. This is where I choose to be. Peacefully. All of them are dead now. So I'll sleep well tonight. No knives to startle me away. Other mothers will be leaning out their windows, hot and spat at by the rain, straining to catch the faces of their sons coming home. Not me. In the peace of my sleep, I'll carve a stone dove. I'll watch it carry camellias to the cemetery. No, not the cemetery. Not the goddamn cemetery to the earth. Just the bed of earth they sleep in under eiderdowns of rocks. A bed that sways in the night. People are coming. Stop covering your face up like that. The bad days haven't begun. I don't want to see anyone. Me and the floor. Four walls. I'm calm. The whole village will be here soon.
I don't want them to see me this poor, without a single son to press to my lips.
Where the hell do you think you're going?
Here. Who is it?
Take a look.
No. Snake. Oh, poor love. She's crying and I'm calm and not ripping her eyeballs out. I don't know why. Did I not love my son? Did I not care about him? Delicate thing, isn't she? Doesn't sleep well.
Don't do that. Just kill me.
It's not her fault. And it's not mine, so whose is it?
Feel my neck. Butter. Easier than cutting a dahlia.
The girl who takes her orange blossom with her and goes looking for a bit of warmed bed.
I didn't.
A deflowered.
No one deflowered me. Nearly, but they didn't. Just kill me. That is why I'm here.
Why would I care about your honor or your life? The wheat is blessed because my children are under it. The rain is blessed because it falls on my son's bodies. God is blessed because he lies us down next to each other to rest. Soft.
Sweet cross. my house.